Picking the right camera for any job can be challenging, but especially when that job is live video streaming. One question we get all the time is whether to buy a DSLR or camcorder for broadcasting live events. So let's take a look at both. Both camcorders and DSLRs can produce very high quality video, but they also have different strengths and weaknesses that will suit them best in certain scenarios. In fact, we use both DSLRs and camcorders in our studio. We'll use multiple camcorders when we live stream our webinars, and when we're filming videos like these, we use DSLRs. Let me add one disclaimer to this video. When I say DSLR, I'm also referring to the mirrorless cameras. So, which camera you go with depends on the type of video you're producing, but more often than not, you'll be better off with a camcorder when you're live streaming events, like conferences, keynote speeches, sporting events, and church services. Let's break it down a little more. When you're live streaming events, you want to be as close to the action as possible, but you aren't always going to be able to position your camera right by your subject. Since you probably can't afford those fancy sky cams they use in the NFL, your best bet is to pick a camera with a good optical zoom ratio and focal length, so your camera can zoom really far in and out. Typically, you'll find that camcorders, which come with built-in lenses, have far better zoom ratios than their DSLR counterparts. Most DSLRs will require you to buy separate photographic lenses with varying zoom capabilities. And as you get lenses with longer zoom capability, you'll start to notice they get pricey. While these lenses create some beautiful images and give you nice shallow depth of field, they're not as functional for zooming in and out because DSLRs don't have zoom rockers on them like most camcorders do. When you're producing live events, you definitely want multiple options for inputs and outputs. Many prosumer and professional level camcorders come with XLR inputs and even SDI outputs, which will suit them better in a variety of video workflows. XLR is great because then you can connect a live mix from your soundboard or a more professional microphone. And then from there, you can even adjust the audio levels. SDI is very nice to have because you can run longer cables and the BNC connector on it actually will lock in, so you don't have to worry about someone pulling out the cable while you're streaming. Now, there's nothing wrong with HDMI outputs. Both DSLR and camcorders come standard with them. My only beef with some DSLRs is that they don't send you a clean video signal, so you likely won't get a full resolution image, but instead something wonky like this. They also don't output audio over HDMI either, which I've had to learn the hard way. So if you're going to use a DSLR for live streaming, just be careful. Make sure that it has a clean HDMI output and can pass audio down that HDMI line as well. We're almost there. Speaking of plugging things in, another great thing we love about camcorders is they come with AC power adapters, so you can plug your camera into a wall outlet and not have to worry about the battery dying while you're streaming. But if you're not by a wall outlet, that's okay, because camcorders usually have pretty decent battery lives anyway. And depending on the camera you buy, you may even be able to purchase larger batteries to last you longer. This is especially useful if you're streaming video all day for an event like a music festival or a corporate conference. Now we're talking about recording. If the events you're looking to stream only last a few minutes, then you'll be okay using a DSLR. But anything over 30 minutes and you may want to start looking at a camcorder. Now, of course, how long you can record for depends on how much space your memory cards have on them. So it's also important to ensure you're buying larger SD cards or CF cards if you plan to record long events on your camera. Camcorders are much better at recording long events and may even have dual SD card slots. So if your recording goes too long, your camera will automatically switch over to the other card to keep it going. This can be really useful when you're in a pinch and forgot to clear your memory cards the night before. Do you feel the pain there? Hashtag videographer problems. Ready for this one? Low light capability. So the one thing a DSLR is going to give you an upper hand on is low light performance. That's because more often than not, they have much larger sensors than camcorders. And a lot of DSLR lenses have larger apertures than the lenses that come baked into camcorders. Boom. But really, any type of organized event that you're planning on broadcasting should be well lit anyway. Otherwise, the people watching on site probably won't be too happy either. So, in conclusion, there's no such thing as the best camera. There's just the best camera for the job. If you're looking to make creative, post-produced video content, like wedding films, highlight reels, or even vlogs like these, then a DSLR will be a perfect fit. If you're interested in broadcasting and recording live events, then you'll probably have more success using a camcorder. You can check out some of our favorite cameras to stream with by clicking the link in the description. And if you have any questions, feel free to let me know in the comments below or reach me anytime at techtips@boxcast.com. Thanks for watching and happy streaming.